Welcome to Raikulpur.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to embed Jira Roadmap within our Confluence pages. Whenever we are working on any projects that will need some documentations to be prepared, it's always suggested to keep these documents on cloud so that all the team members will be able to access it from anywhere and anytime. So Confluence will always help us to meet this motto. Here, within the documentation, sometimes we also need to add some of the charts as well as roadmap or timeline to be added within our Confluence page. In that case, it's very easy to add it for user who is not using Confluence frequently, they are not aware of it. So here I will explain you how we can embed roadmap within our Confluence pages. If you want to learn more about Jira and automation product, feel free to watch my Jira and Confluence playlist. I've also created automations and Jira API playlist as well, which will help you to get more learning from these playlists. I've also created one of the course on Jira from Scrum Master and Project Managers. And trust me, this is not only relevant to Scrum Master and Project Manager. This course will also be useful for the testers and developers who are learning Jira from scratch. So this course is very cost efficient. This will help you to understand complete Jira in detail. If you want to opt this out, include the URL in discussion tab so that you can quickly access it. Now, let's go back to our main topic where we are trying to embed roadmap within our Confluence page. Let me select any page and within this page, we will add or embed roadmap. Now here, let me edit this. Click on add it, and from this sections, simply click on /, and within this, just type roadmap, or you can search the roadmap from here, or just type timeline. Now you can see Jira timeline available here. You need to enter the Jira instance URL. So I will just open it from here. I want to access this project. So get shareable link from this sections and then paste it to here. It will auto detect your project name and board name, and you can see who is added successfully, where you can see sprint and release detail as well. If you want to keep monthly, quarterly, or any format, you can keep this information available. This board is not having any data, but even if you want to add these details, you can quickly add it. Now, let me show you within my trial version instance where I added a lot of informations within that. So over there, you will see all those informations are quickly available. Now here, if I wanted to add my roadmap sections, I've clicked on edit. And from this, you can see I already added this roadmap exactly similar way which we have used earlier. Here you can see sprint, release, and all those informations are available because this project contains some data. Now you can apply the filter by quarterly, monthly, weekly, and daily basis, which will give you the complete detail about this roadmap. After that, if you want, let me remove this section, this one, just select this option and you can see event timeline is also populating. After that, you have URL sections. If you just wanted to see based on the URL, you will be able to see it very quickly. Even you can sort it out these two column bases. And here, if you want to see just add a tab, that is also available. So whenever a user will click on this tab, it will navigate into the roadmap. So this documentation will looks like very pretty, because sometimes documentations or Confluence pages are very much bulky. In that case, these settings will help us to streamline our content. If you want to showcase as a card, that is also available, where you can see open preview sections. And once you click on this preview sections, this will launch a new tab where you'll have the complete dashboards available. So this is not just showing your dashboards or a roadmap or timeline. This is also giving a flexibility to edit these components. Now here we have the smaller sections or smaller piece of information available in this, where you will have this timeline in short form. Other than that, you can also align to left, right, and center. We can also wrap it to left or right. We can also get edit links. Other than that, put link in new tab if you want to see complete dashboard or timeline or roadmap into new tab. You can have the complete Jira products available. Next, we also have the copy sections, and after that, we can click on Atlassian account settings, where you can customize your projects or instance. After that, if you want to remove, simply click on delete icon, and this will remove permanently, or timeline will be removed from this page. It will not remove from your Atlassian instance, but it will remove from this page or block. This is how we can embed roadmap within our Confluence pages, which will help you understand the timeline or the project timeline of any particular projects. Generally, when we are creating kickoff meeting or when we are reviewing our sprint and noting all those pointers within the Confluence pages, this point of time will be required to see the timeline. And sometimes when we are not using this type of applications or we are not using Confluence, we are normally taking snap of it and attaching within that documents. But Atlassian is giving flexibility to add all those informations or embed this roadmap or timeline within our Confluence pages. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And if you have any feedback or suggestions related to the further topics, feel free to add in the comment sections. I will definitely come up with a video of that topic mentioned by you. If you want to learn more from me and you want to get connected with me, always reach out to me via email. Thank you.